In a few moments, we shall bring you the dramatic second act of Wagner's majestic music drama, Die Walküre. During the intermission, our commentator, Marcia Davenport, will give a colorful word picture of the opera and the artists appearing here tonight. For those of our listeners who may wish to know something of the personality of our charming young commentator, we give a brief sketch. An attractive brunette with dark, smiling eyes. Marcia Davenport is thoroughly American, frank and unaffected, with a cosmopolitan manner through which peeps an engaging ingenuousness. Acclaimed as the author of a bestseller, her biography of Mozart, Marcia Davenport now adds a novel on the life of an opera singer to her achievement in American literature. Marcia Davenport.
Thank you, Mr. Presby. Tonight, the opera is Die Walküre, the second of the Nibelungen Ring tetralogy. Wagner is now the supreme favorite of American operatic audiences, and we know that you are welcoming this music with particular joy. But when I tell you the details of tonight's performance, I think you will agree that we are listening to the most extraordinary cast that has sung a Wagner opera in this country in many years. I am going so far as to say that it is the finest cast for Die Walküre that could be assembled today. The artists are so famous that I only need to name them to introduce them. The Brünnhilde is Kirsten Flagstad. The Sieglinde is Lotte Lehmann. The Siegmund is Lauritz Melchior. The Wotan is Friedrich Schor. The Fricker is Catherine Meisley. The Hunding, Emmanuel Liszt. Now, you have all heard these singers on the air before, often in broadcasts from the Metropolitan Opera, to which they belong. But neither you nor anybody else in the present day has heard a Walküre with the two greatest living Wagnerian sopranos both singing in the cast together. And that is what you will hear tonight. I want to talk to you about the two truly great sopranos who are singing for us tonight. Die Walküre is one of those extremely rare operas that contains parts for two leading sopranos. Neither part is considered more important than the other, and both are nothing less than terrific to sing. But there is a difference between the two parts. And the difference is the same one that lies in the voices of Lotte Lehmann and Kirsten Flagstad. You might say that one is woman and the other is superwoman. Madame Flagstad, who sings the goddess Brünnhilde, is the ideal hochdramatische or super dramatic heroic soprano. The size and power of her voice are unlimited. It has great nobility and purity, and it has a fantastically true quality of heroic splendor, soaring over the heaviest orchestral passages. Now, Lotte Lehmann is also a dramatic soprano, but of a very different type. Her ideal parts are those where she is the completely feminine, emotional, human woman. Sieglinde is such a part, a tragic mortal, a helpless victim of destiny. Sieglinde's music is passionate love music, intensified by emotions of terror and loneliness, while Brünnhilde in Die Walküre is still untouched by mortal love. Her music is full of Amazonian war cries and noble defiance. There is one heroic tenor who sings these great Wagnerian parts as they were meant to be sung, and that is Lauritz Melchior. Mr. Melchior is a tremendous figure of a man, way over 6 feet tall, and every inch the Nordic hero he sings. His voice is peculiarly brilliant and strong. The second act of Die Walküre has been chosen for this broadcast because it is the only one of the opera in which all the principal characters appear. It gives you a complete picture in one act of the spirit of the Nibelungen Ring. Incidentally, you hear much thunder and lightning toward the end of the act. If you hear any other noises, it will be the prompter whom we cannot help taking in on the microphone which stands near his box. And here is Fritz Reiner, one of the foremost conductors, a musician's conductor, honored by all musicians as well as by his public, stepping onto his stand to begin the second act of Die Walküre.
Oh! Oh, Thank you. Hunger, Liebe, Lust, mir verblich, verlangte nach Macht mein Mut. Von Scherwünsche Güten gejagt, gefand ich mir die Welt. Unwissend, voll und träumlich, ahnt durch Verträge, was Unheil ward. Lockte mich Lobe, der Streifen nun verschwand. Von der Liebe noch mocht ich dich lassen, in der Macht verlangt ich nach mir. In Nachtgebar, verfangen Lieben und Albrecht, saß in den Bund. Fluchte der Lieb und gewann durch den Fluch des reines glänzendes Gold und mit ihm maßlose Macht. Und ringte der Fluch, entriss ich ihm listig, doch nicht überrein hab ich ihn zurück. Mit ihm bezahlt ich all als Zinnen der Burg. Wir hießen wir Pfaufen, aus der ich vor Fälschung gebot. Wie alles weit vereinten war, ihr da, die Feiligkeit des Walla, lief mir ab von dem Ring, ahnte vor ewigem Ende. Von dem Ende wollte ich mehr noch wissen, doch schweigend entspannt ihr das Weib, da verlor ich den leichten Tod. O Wissen, begehrtesten Gott, in den Schoß der Welt schwang ich mich hinab, mit dem Liebeszauber schwang ich die Walla, gib mir des Wissens stolz, dass die Rede nun mir stand. Und empfing ich von ihm, von mir noch war.
Mit Gewalt Ich bin nicht Mann, alle der Kühne geht im Park. Wer bist du, als meine Schülern, ihre Seele fehlt? Hab ich dir nicht abgefangen, dich zu sehen, dass du siebst der einige Köpfe warst, Mensch und Mensch, mein Freund. Und sag dir ein Wort, wenn jeder Mal, wenn du auf dich hörst, dein Tag. Im Boden täglich den Grimm der Grauen und Wut wirft in den Fest, die als Lust mir gelacht. Wehe dem, den er frisst, trauer Köpfe sein Kopf. Und was ich dir verbreite mit Glück, Sorge, was ich befall, Krieg und Halle. Es sei der Walküre
Grad und Stur, immer fest und stein. Brach du schweigen, brach du dahin, ein Ruf in die Verdacht.
Thank you. Ich bin ein Mann, 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 ich bin ein Thank you. Lektion am Buch. Ich bin auf dem Weg.